What is going on, my fellow Fat Kids? Here we are with the second episode of my Fixing NHL Team Series. First, I did my favorite team, which is the Habs, and from now on, unless there are suggestions in the comments, I will just be using a random team generator to determine which team I will fix next. Today, on the chopping block, we have the Oilers. Right now, the Oilers are in the weakest division possibly in any of the Big Four sports leagues for this upcoming season. So this is the year that they really have to go for it all before teams like LA or Anaheim start to become good again. On their to-do list this offseason is to weaponize their cap space to find McDavid a true first liner to play on his left side, solve the problem in net, and fill in any holes from players who left in free agency. First up, we have the expansion pick, who I predict will be Benson. This would be a pretty big loss for Edmonton, as he has shown a lot of promise to be a middle six, potentially even top six player for the Oilers, while playing for Bakersfield this past few seasons. At only 23 years old, he still has time to blossom into a great NHL player, and if I was the Oilers, I would try and make some sort of deal with Seattle so they don't take him. Okay, now it's time for the actual trades. Here we have a very minor deal, which sends Kyle Turris, someone who has been an absolute disaster with Edmonton, to Buffalo, a team who will probably be looking to remake their entire roster this offseason. It gives Buffalo a potential third-line center, while Edmonton gets that little bit of cap relief to make other moves. So now that we have that $1.6 million off the books, let's finally get McDavid his left winger. And that left winger is Philip Forsberg. It's been rumored for a long time that Edmonton would be willing to move this first for immediate help, and that's what they're doing here. Nashville seems to be heading in a rebuilding direction with the Arvidsson trade, so I do think that it's plausible for Forsberg to be available. As his RAPM shows, he's not quite living up to his offensive potential, and I think that playing with McDavid would unleash a 40-goal Philip Forsberg that we have just never seen before. Nashville here gets some high picks and a B-level prospect for someone who no longer fits their timeline. With only 1 year left on his deal, depending on how he does with McDavid, he can either re-sign, or he can just walk in free agency to make some room for some young defenders whose contracts will be up next season. So that's the last of the trades that I had in store for Edmonton. So now, let's get into their RFA and UFA signings. Here, we have just a couple RFA signings. So first, we're going to want to get Yamo on a cheap bridge contract after his disappointing season this year, and then also sign Kara for 1 year just to round out the bottom six. So not a lot going on for the RFAs, but the UFAs have quite a bit to go over, so let's get into it. First, we're going to sign Chiasson for a chippy fourth-line role player who can pot 10 to 15 goals a year. Smith had a great year. If he's not retiring, please be sure to bring him back on a one-year deal. Larson, while providing almost nothing offensively, has been consistently great as a shutdown guy. Be sure to lock him up. Now, we have the big one. Dougie Hamilton. In this simulation, we're letting Barry walk because, well, of course we are. So, we needed someone to replace him on the blue line as an offensive presence. Enter Dougie Hamilton. This guy is an absolute Norris-caliber defenseman year in and year out. Top 3 offensive defenseman in the league while still being well above average defensively. If Edmonton could lock him down at this price, it would be an absolute steal. Next, we have Ennis and Paquette to round out the fourth line. They won't provide much offense, but they're both pretty serviceable defensively. And on a team as top heavy as this one, that's really all you need from your bottom six. And finally here, we have Dreger to be our starting goalie. He hasn't had a full year as a starter, so personally, I'd only feel comfortable giving him 1 year. That is it. That is all. That is all the moves that I have planned for the Edmonton Oilers this offseason. So now, let's take a look at the new roster, and then that will be that. I feel like this team will be competing for the President's Trophy next season. Their top two lines are absolutely lethal offensively, and you have McLeod on the third line to provide a little scoring flair in the bottom six. On the back end, adding Hamilton is a complete game changer for Edmonton, and hopefully Dreger can replicate his play from last season in Edmonton. Well, that's all from me. Thanks for watching.